Hi, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to run a sample of some chromite that came from South Africa. This is about 31% CR203, so it's a chrome oxide, and this is a byproduct from a chrome refinery down in South Africa, and they're looking to upgrade this to mostly chrome and get the iron and the silica and the aluminum out, and so they can have a high chrome product that they can refine later. So we're going to run it on one of our 4x8 shaker tables behind me, and we'll show you the results. So we're starting to feed the sample now, and I'm going to feed it pretty slow because there's so much chrome in it, and chrome's so dense that we're going to get a whole lot of concentrate. And we're going to run about a third of the sample or so, and send the results to the customer. And that way, if he wants to do something different or change things, we still have some sample left to run. So here's the heaviest material coming off here. It's actually white. I thought the chrome oxide would be a black, but whatever this is the heaviest stuff. Adjust the water bar a little bit. Try and get some of this chrome up under the water bar, but looks like there's actually bigger flakes and flecks coming out, and this fine stuff is coming across. And like I say, I'm feeding this pretty slow because I don't know how it's going to react on the table. I don't want to overwhelm the concentrates. When we run samples, it's hard to know exactly what's going to happen. So I always start out slow and then ramp up from there because we're working with such a limited amount of material. So here's the heavy material coming down under the water bar. These bigger pieces are dense as well, but they're so large and they have a big enough cross-section. The water bar is actually pushing them down. They'll come across into the number two here. The grooves have actually been overwhelmed by the material. There's so much that it can't all come up the groove, so it's forming another band down here. It's coming down, and it's being caught by our two safety grooves to come across here, and there's very little going down into the number three middlings. I'm going to play with the splitter here a little bit. So I'm going to turn this around. And now we have anything that comes down here, and we'll catch a little bit of the waste, and all the rest is going off to the waste now. So now I fed it a little bit too fast. You can see we're getting some chrome. I think that's chrome into the number three middlings, which is fine. And we can rerun the middlings to upgrade them, or we can just do the splitter and take a little bit of waste and get all of our chrome here. The key to running the shaker table is a nice consistent feed, and even grade, and it's hard to do when I'm shoveling with a little trowel and trying to adjust things. So we're going to get some ebbs and flows in the concentrate, but that's okay. We're doing our sample, we're running it, everything's working out real good, and as you can see, we're getting real good separation of the densest material from the black waste. All right, so here's the results from our shaker table test. Here's the number one. As you can see, it's mostly fine stuff, but it is pretty much pure chrome, I believe. And it's really heavy for how much volume is in there. Here's the number two. Again, pretty much pure chrome, but you can see this is where the more dense stuff, or the larger pieces went. So it's not as fine material, it's a little bit more coarse. And then here's the number three, and like I explained earlier, the number three, when I'm running samples, I like to catch some waste just so I don't lose any chrome. But you can see there's a lot of chrome. It's probably more than half chrome. The bucket weighs a lot. And again, I had the splitter set back, so if I overfed it, I wouldn't lose any chrome. When you set the table up and you're running in production, it's really easy to dial in the feed, and then you can move your splitter, so you're separating pretty much the stuff you want from the stuff you don't. But when I'm running samples, it's hard because I'm feeding and it's surging and I'm adjusting things on the table. So that's why there's a little bit of contamination in here. This could easily be upgraded again, rerun back on the table, or if you wanted to get a pure product, you could run the number three directly onto a second table that would upgrade just your number three. But looking at how the table ran, there shouldn't be anything in the number four in the waste. It all got caught in the number three. And like I said, I took a little bit of waste with the number three just so I had good recovery. So thanks for watching our sample and our video. I think it went great. I think it really proved how the shaker table can separate by density. And the chrome that we're separating is about 5.5 grams per cubic centimeter. So it's really not that dense compared to some of the heavier metals and stuff we have been working with, like gold and copper. So even though the quote-unquote lighter material separates really nicely on our shaker table. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.